Chapter 3. Feats of Learning. Personally, I'm always ready to learn, although I do not always like being taught. Quote from Sir Winston Churchill, 1874 to 1965. Introduction. Learning is an active process. The word learn means to acquire knowledge of or skill in by study, instruction, or experience. The word feat is defined as an act of skill, endurance, imagination, or strength, an achievement. Feats of learning means acquiring knowledge by studying skillfully. The intent of this book is to help you study skillfully and efficiently. To get to this point in your education, you've learned how to read, write, apply abstract reasoning, solve complex equations, etc. If you're lucky, you also gain skills in music, the arts, and sports. You zeroed in on your passion to help others and worked incredibly hard to get into medical school. Along the way, you adapted to different teaching styles and subject matter. You've had to make good grades and be successful in class and on paper. Depending on how your brain is wired, you either found a way to be successful in all forms of testing, i.e., multiple choice, short answer, oral exams, lab practicals, term papers, scholarly projects, etc., or you made it through not knowing exactly how you did it. I believe that learning preferences come into play. Depending on whom you read, the preferences are organized as follows. 1. Somatic or kinesthetic. 2. Auditory. 3. Visual. 4. Intellectual. If you've read anything on accelerated learning, that's the heart of Dave Meyer's SAVI system in his book, The Accelerated Learning Handbook. SAVI, S-A-V-I, is the first letter of each of the learning preferences listed above. Some educators think learning preferences or styles don't really exist. I don't take such a hard line. In the coaching I've done with medical students, using the idea of learning preferences has provided a framework and a starting point to aid in revamping and reorganizing failed approaches to step one study. As you've probably gathered by now, I like to change things around so they're easier to remember and more applicable to my teaching style. Think of the following as learning tags. Simply put, how do you learn best? Do you learn best by sight, the power or faculty of seeing, perception of objects by use of the eyes, vision, sound, the sensation produced by stimulation of the organs of hearing by vibrations transmitted through the air or other medium, motion, the action or process of moving or of changing place or position, movement, muse, to think or meditate in silence, as on some subject? Or do you learn by a combination of some or all of the above? In the next sections, I'll elaborate on each learning preference and help you identify how you learn best. Finally, I'll encourage you to try a study style makeover and see if you might be able to try a slightly different approach to studying for step one. Learning tags: sight, sound, motion, and muse. According to Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia, a tag is a relevant keyword or term associated with or assigned to a piece of information, e.g. a picture, article, or video clip, thus describing the item and enabling keyword-based classification of information. I want you to think about how you would tag yourself. I realize that tagging yourself may seem weird, but give it a try anyway. Examples of each tag with a little more description include: sight learning emphasizes seeing, observing, and mind mapping. Think looking at a video, through a microscope, or at a chart. Sound learning emphasizes hearing, listening, and talking. Think lectures, audio programs, etc. Motion learning emphasizes moving and hands-on experiences. Think tying knots, handling surgical instruments, etc. Muse learning emphasizes thinking, problem-solving, and planning. Think scientific method or pondering a specific question, etc. The tags for sight, sound, motion, and muse should elicit some kind of response in you, such as, "Oh, I'm a lecture person. If I hear it once, I can remember it, no problem. I respond to sound." Another example might be, "I love to think about things. Work a problem in my mind. Contemplate. I guess I tag myself as muse." The point of all of this is to help you identify how you've been learning up to this point. It doesn't matter whether you lean toward one tag or a combination of all four. It's something you need to muse about, because once you're consciously aware of how you learn, you have an opportunity to experiment with the other ways. Studying for multiple choice exams can be boring. In later chapters, you'll see how knowing your tag and being open to trying other learning techniques can help you in your step one preparation. step by step, putting it together. In Stephen Sondheim's musical, Sunday in the Park with George, the characters sing the song, Putting It Together, as they discuss the difficulties of putting an artistic enterprise together and the steps it takes to do it. This book is intended to help you put it together and pass your step one enterprise, exam. The next chapters are designed to help you maximize your learning preferences or tags. Many of my students have rediscovered former approaches to learning that they unknowingly discarded in the past. They assume they were putting it together because the learning styles they were using prior to medical school worked fine when they were in college. They now realize that medical school isn't undergrad and that it may take a different strategy to succeed. So now that you know something about your learning preferences, here's the good news and the bad news as they apply to studying for Step 1 and the Aim Your Brain study system. The good news is, if you're inclined towards sight, sound, or motion, there are specific things you can do that will help you get through your online question banks and factoid book review. Factoid is an acronym for Frequently Asked Concepts to Own in Depth. And a factoid book is the spiral-bound notebook you create for those concepts that are giving you trouble. If you're more of a muser, you'll have to expand your horizons and add sight, sound, or both skills to your repertoire and reduce your musing time while studying for Step 1. If you muse your way through your review, you'll probably run out of time without finishing the Aim Your Brain study system. If you must muse, then set a specific amount of time per day, say 10 to 20 minutes. Your sight and sound skills should be your main emphasis as you study for Step 1. All of you motion learners might be wondering, what about me? As a motion learner, you need to think about creating your factoid book as part of the motion. That is, writing up the wrongs, turning pages during your review, making flashcards, etc. Just as with muse learners, you need to develop your sight and sound approaches to learning. You're going to learn about the Aim Your Brain study system and how mixing up the tags will help you avoid boredom and/or feeling overwhelmed. You'll finally be able to take advantage of downtime. You'll be able to reformat the information going in and out of your brain so it'll be more multiple-choice question accessible. You'll be studying more skillfully and efficiently as you tune in to your own feats of learning.